What's up, guys? I'm BTC. Welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved. I'm here on the Pooping Evolve server. Thank you guys for joining me today. Hope you enjoy the video. If you do, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe if you're new. I've done a little bit of maintenance work on the base here. As you can see, it's a little bit more organized, and I moved the food troughs over here. So now they should be able to hit absolutely everything, including the stuff that's way over here. So this is kind of like the unwanted area. Look at all the poop! Look at all that poop. This is kind of like the, don't tell them that, but it's kind of like the useless zone. They don't actually do anything, so I just put them over here. Well, it's better than killing them, right? I mean, it's better a better fate than some of the other dinos that I had in the monster truck rally, right? So, anyways, so it is a little bit more organized here, but there are still a few things that I need to change. So first up is I want to put these beetles in the wooden cages instead of having them in this little thing right here, because it's kind of annoying trying to deal with these things because they're constantly moving around, and like sometimes they try to escape but they can't actually fit through the door and they get stuck and it's just a pain. So I saw D-Mac had his dung beetles in the cages and that seemed to work really, really well. So I am gonna do that, and also I need to kind of put up like a little baby fence for the Quetzals here because, well, you guys might be experiencing this problem as well, but there is a kind of a, I guess it's not really a bug, but it's kind of like an unintended thing that happens to all the different flying animals. So let me show you real quick what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna quickly explain something, and then hopefully you'll understand why I have to put up like the little baby gates for the Quetzals. So I'm gonna put Poopy up here on the second floor with John Cena. And I'm gonna demonstrate something. So, whenever an area loads, the dinos load first, and then like a split second later, the world loads. If you've ever noticed some of your dinos seem to like fall through your building and then they get stuck under the floor, that's why. It's because the dinos load first, gravity pulls them down, and then the world loads, so the game thinks that your dino is actually underneath the floor. Now, what happens with flying animals is a little extra annoying because, well, let me show you. So I got Poopy here, and I'm gonna walk Poopy off the edge of the cliff. So when Poopy falls, it looks like he's just walking. Like, he just has a normal walking animation, and it just falls off the edge. But whenever you have a flying animal, so this could be a Quetzal, a Dimorphodon, a Pterodon, or an Argy. So whenever a flying animal starts that fall, it actually changes into flight mode, but it's not actually flying. Gravity is pulling it down, but it goes into flight mode. So basically, what ends up happening is when the area loads in, the dino starts to fall, and if it's a flying creature, it spreads its wings, but then the game loads in the world, and it instantly tells the Argy or the Quetzal, like, oh, no, 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 you're actually on the ground. So then it closes its wings, but when it does that, it moves ever so slightly forward. So that's what keeps happening with all of my Quetzals and all that. Look at these Argies. They're, like, all over the place now. And the Quetzals keep trying to jump off the cliff over here. I had a couple of other Argies over here, but I had to move them. Let me show you. I have these Argies. They're now like facing this wall here, so they can't actually move away. Same thing with the Dimorphodon. I put the Dimorphodon right here as a test, and like a day or two later, the darn thing was underneath the ramp. Like, that's how far it traveled. And I also had to put some extra railings and stuff up here so that the Argies wouldn't jump off the edge, because I came in one day And like the RG, I only had one RG up here at the time. And I was like, where did the RG go? And I found it on the ground down there. So that's what the deal is. So if your stuff is moving around, like your Quetzals and your RGs and Dimetrodons and Dimorphodons. No, not Dimetrodons. If your Dimetrodons are flying, you have a problem. Pterodons and Dimorphodons. Those are the four. So if those are moving around, that's why. Funny enough, bats are not technically flying according to the game. Since they don't have the ability to land, they're not actually flying. There's just like a flag that's, you know, checked in the programming code for the bats that just says gravity doesn't affect this animal ever. So that's why bats don't ever fall and they don't move forward. Also, funny enough, they used to not take the extra damage that flying animals used to take either. So bats are just weird. They're not really flying. They just kind of like move around. I don't know, whatever. All right, so I got to move all of these Quetzals here. I'm going to get these out of the way. And then I'm going to put up the little Quetzal baby gate using the fence foundations and just some wooden walls. The Quetzal baby gate is now in place and it runs all the way down the line here. And I did put John Cena, my Pterodon, and these two extra RGs that I have in here as well. And I put an extra wall on the ends of it as well. The reason for that is because you'll never get your Quetzal or your RGs or whatever to point exactly straight ahead. They're always going to be turned ever so slightly to the left or ever so slightly to the right. And when that happens, when they try to move forward, eventually they'll work their way out of the wall. So if there's a little bit of a corner, then you're not going to have that problem. And if you're wondering if I'm going to build one for the other RGs over there, no, I don't really care because those are just getting bred for color. And then once I'm done, it'll be monster truck time for those. So, oh, excuse me. Oh, you know what? Let me actually grab this. And I'm going to... Where should I put this? You know what? I'm going to leave this one like right here for right now. No, I don't want to pick up the stone. I want to throw the... There you go. All right, you just sit there and contemplate life, I guess. I don't know. All right, so let me shut off the wandering on all of these. So that way I don't have to deal with them going all over the place. All right, everybody stop. 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 Okay, we're good. All right, so now I'm going to tear down all of this stuff here, and this is gonna be a super pain. Oh, I'm sure getting these beetles inside the gates is probably gonna be a super big pain. All right, so let's see. We're gonna craft, and I'm gonna make four of these cages. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and let's get these beetles to follow me now, and I'm gonna get them over here. So this is, oh man, this is going to be such a pain. This is going to be such a pain. All right, everybody over here. Come on. Come on. You too. You too. You too. Come on. Come on. It's not you two. It's the beetles. Come on. Get over here. Get over here. Stop hitting against the wall. Oh my God. These things are so slow. These things are so slow. They're like as slow as the baby RGs. Oh, come on, man. Come on. Over here, please. Over here. Oh my God, these things are so slow. All right, good. Great. Now, what do I have in here? Do I have anything of value? Nope. So we're just gonna get rid of that. And what do I have in here? Probably, oh, nothing. Okay, I thought I might have a little bit of oil or something in there. Do I need to get rid of this? Yeah, why not? All right, we'll just tear down all of it. Whatever, I don't care. Just tear it all down. All right, so gonna grab all of this and get all of this out of the way. All right, now, let's see. Where do I want to start putting this? Probably right on the edge. You know what, Dimorphodon? I got a bad... You know what, you can just... All right, fine. I've been neglecting you. You can sit on the shoulder for a little while, okay? As long as you don't cause problems, Don't poop on me. We'll be fine. All right, so let's see here. What do I want to do? I think I'm going to put it right here. Is it against the wall? It looks like it's pretty darn close to the wall. So let's just put it right here. And then I'm going to put another one right here. And then we'll get another one. And then we'll get the last one right there. Okay. Oh man, this is going to be this is going to be such a pain to get them in there. All right. Let's go with the first one. And let's see if all right, I'm going to like try to line it up. All right, so how many away from the wall is this? So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you stay right there, so I gotta kind of like trick them. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right, we're gonna do this blind. Come on, beetle. Come on. It's like a little mini game. Come on. Which cage will it go in? Which cage will it go in? Are you in a cage? Are you in a cage, or are you just wandering around? I think you're just wandering around. What are you doing? I see you move. Hello. Oh my god. All right. Hold on. You know what I might? Oh my god. You know what I might end up having to do? Hold on. I got an idea. It's not exactly the nicest thing. How much health do you have? 840. Oh, that's plenty. That works. Oh, that works great. That works just fine. That works. That works just fine. We're gonna close the cage, and we're gonna. Oh no, we don't want to pick it up. Wait. Can I? I thought I could. Okay. Oh, there we go. All right. Enable wandering. There we go. Mission successful. Okay. Let's get the other one in here. All right. Hold on. You know what I'm gonna do? Let's do this. Let's beetle punching. All right. Everybody over here. Over here. Oh, come on. Get as close to the cage. If you want to save yourself from a spanking, get in the cage. That sounds so wrong. That sounds so wrong. Hold on. All right, how close? Oh, you're pretty close. You just get your butt in there. All right. And then how about you? You get... get your butt in there. Just get your butt in there. And wow. That is a lot easier than trying to get them to follow me in. May not be as nice, but it works. And then enable wandering. Close this. And then enable wandering. Close that. And no, we don't want to demolish the cage. Enable wandering. There we go. Awesome. So now, are you floating? Are you floating in there? You're floating. That's a magic beetle. Okay, are you like a scarab? Are you gonna lead Aladdin to the genie lamp or something? No? Okay, alright, we're good. Oh, that's awesome! Oh man, that is so much easier now. Oh, that's gonna be so much easier. Just come over here and... Oh yeah, that is way, way easier than having this stupid fence thing. Ah, you know what? I'm gonna leave that right there. Just because I can. Oh, you know what? Hold on. Where's the Demorphodon? Oh, the Demorphodon's on my shoulder. Alright, hold on. We're gonna... You know what I'm gonna do? We're gonna put the Demorphodon right there. There you go. And because it's angled a little to the left, it's probably gonna, like, work its way into the corner. And then it'll have a nice little place to hang out and chill. There you go. Awesome. Very, very, very good. Very good. Alright guys, so there is someone on the server that I have never introduced you to. It is Wells Knight. It's him right there.
Hello.
How you doing, man?
Pretty good. How are you, man?
Not too bad. I've got like a half submerged kangaroo, so I'm
doing I see that. It's swimming.
Doing pretty awesome. I really like this thing. This was the first kangaroo I ever found, and it was like a 112 or something like that. They're so awesome, but I don't know, man. Like, They're not very useful. They're really cool, but they're not useful. I don't know.
Well, how many dinosaurs do you have that can go swimming in vaults?
Yeah, I mean, it's like this is true. This is true.
It's like a ghost kangaroo.
So I have a bunch of RGs that I don't really need anymore. So you can have one of these two right here. These are both level 241s. They're males. They haven't been leveled at all. That's their base level. They're some of the best on the server. I think DMAC has bred some that are like 246 or 250 or something like that. They have a little bit more health. But other than that, these are like top of the line, grade A RGs. They're like some of the best that you can get. So you can take
nice.
It. Take whichever one you want. And
I think I'll, let's see. Ooh, decisions. They look identical.
They are identical.
And you know, interestingly enough, they're the exact same color pattern
yeah.
that my other two RGs are.
Oh, really?
So I'm going to have three identical looking RGs.
Okay. I'm actually trying to breed a different color RG. Like, now that I have the levels and stuff, I've been taming like a bunch of crappy low level RGs. And I've got them, like, way on the other side of my base, but they're, like, black and red, and so far they're looking pretty cool. And I might also tame some of the black and white ones, too. So these are the black and white ones, but the black and the red ones are over here, so these look really cool.
Yeah, that's a good look.
I'm going to try to get an all-red one and an all-black one.
Nice.
Yeah, it's going to be...
I think I'll probably grab the one on the left.
Okay. Yeah, it's going to be a super pain, though, because those things are so low level that, like, once I get the color, then I'm going to have to breed all the stats into it, and it's just going to be a pain, but whatever.
Yeah. I haven't even dived into any breeding yet. I'm lagging behind. I'm slacking, man.
Yeah. Well, Okay, so you can have that RG. Do you want any extras, like backups or anything? Because I have... I have eggs if you want to incubate an RG egg.
I do have a bunch of eggs. I think I'm probably good with just the RG, honestly.
Okay. All right. No problem.
Yeah, thanks for the offer, though. I appreciate it.
No problem.
All right. Let's see here.
They're going to be all slow, right,
so
by the way.
Gotta be...
They're going to be...
Yeah, got to be... That's all right. Got to be unclaimed before I can...
Oh, that's right. Sorry. I totally forgot about that. It's like the whole different... Yeah, I totally forgot about that. All right, unclaimed. And go. You can keep the
there
saddle, too.
Thank you, man.
I totally forgot about that, because we have the different tribes this season.
Yeah, I'm sitting here like, well, you know what?
I can't take
I'm waiting.
It. Can I have the keys? Can I have the keys, please?
Yeah, Please, Dad, can I have the keys?
All right, well, enjoy it. And guys, if you want to see Wells Knight, go and check out his channel. There's going to be a link in the description.
Yeah, much appreciated, man. Thanks for the RG.
No problem. Have a good one, dude.
You too.
I've been making trips into the lava cave in order to get the Artifact of the Massive, and I also made a whole bunch of the trophy bases. You can actually see my cave RG way down there. It's level 255. I actually don't even have to fight most of the stuff in there. Because the bats don't like to follow you around corners, what I'll do is I'll just, you know, fly in a circle until I have like 100 bats chasing me. And then you just do a sharp turn around a corner and then they all get stuck and they can't actually follow you. So it makes it really easy to get the item drops and the artifact. Although the only item drops I've been getting in there have been pretty garbage. I think I got like a stego saddle or a trike saddle or something like that. So, whatever. All right. So for the trophy bases, I was thinking about putting a bunch of them in here. And let's see how this looks. If I can get this like lined up nice and centered with the thing here. All right. So that actually looks pretty good right there. That looks pretty good. Wow, first try. So how about right about there? Yeah, that looks... I think that's good. Is that good? That looks good. That looks good. You know, actually, no, hold on. It needs to turn ever so slightly to the right. There we go. And, okay. I think that's perfect. That looks pretty good to me. Good enough. Maybe a little to the left. Oh, God. Oh, okay. Hold on. Hold on. Alright. Is that good? Is that good? Is that good? I think that's good. Alright. Bam! Oh, can I paint these? I wonder if I can paint these. Let's put the trophy in there. It's kind of funny because you have to put the trophy in the inventory, then you have to move it to there. And ta-da! There we go. Artifact of the Massive. Oh man, this base is really starting to look good. Now that I've got everything like all sorted and nice and neat. Look at that. Look at this. Yeah, I really like this. I do need to finish this. I gotta take another trip up to the volcano because I have no metal left whatsoever. And then look at this, man. Look at this. That looks so cool. That looks so cool. Look, I was so excited I pooped myself. That looks awesome, though. I got the other bases down right there. See, they look a lot better at nighttime. Like, I don't know what it is, but for some reason, the lighting just kind of, like, the natural sunlight kind of, like, messes with the colors of, like, the ramps and different things. But, like, at nighttime, the trophy bases look way better than they do during the day. But that looks cool. So a couple of the artifacts are green. I think three of them are green. This one's turquoise. One of them is red. And one is purple. I don't know if I want to mix and match here. Or if I just want to make them all the turquoise. It has to match with the environment here. Or with the rest of the base. So like if I was to put like a couple of green ones and then red ones, it would probably, you know, just look like a big mess. So I think maybe if I just put them all as the turquoise, that would be fine. Like, I really like the purple as well, but I don't know if it quite matches with the base. But anyways, I think the base is coming along pretty sweet. I mean, look at that. That is just awesome, man. That is just awesome. And now I got the baby gate up, so I don't have to worry about my Quetzals jumping off the cliff. Coming together nicely. Even with, I think there's a little bit of fog here. Is it fog? I don't know. I can't tell. I think that's going to be it for today, though, guys. The new cages for the beetles work amazing, by the way. I've already been filling them up. It just works so good. So easy to just come over and, like, you know, open the inventory of them and not have to go through all that other stuff with, like, the door and stuff here. So, you having a good time? Having a good time? Yeah? Yeah? You having a good time? Good time? Yeah? Okay. Anyways, guys, that is going to be about it for today. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Hit that like button as we sail off into the sunset. Thank you for watching. Remember, always blame the controller because it's never your fault.